So, hello mga Jo. So, for today's vlog, samahan nyo lang ako mag-unbox ng mga gamit na dumating sa bahay. So, yeah. Madali lang to. This is going to be a quick video. So, remember, nung bumili ako ng grill para sa amin ni Mrs. para sa bahay, para makapag-grill kami ng mga ihaw-ihaw, mga food, o yung mga like liempo, inasal, or anything, mga isaw. So, ginamit ko yun. And of course, syempre, pagka nag-ihaw ka, hindi naman may iiwan na malinis yun. So, bumili ako ng mga tools din. Like, for example, so, itong binili kong una would be yung Thai Masi. This is yung parang nakita ko sa Amazon. Ito yung bestseller. Mura, bestseller, maganda yung reviews. Kaya, why not, diba? Kung bestseller naman, marami ang nagtitestify na maganda. Might as well follow it. So, this is yung, so, meron mga, I don't know. Hindi ko pa nabubuksan talaga fully. Kasi, yeah, walang time din. So, anyway, so, ito yung mga yan. Ito yung panglinis. Brush, for example. Kung makikita ninyo. So, brush. Kunyari, kailangan kong mag oil or mga, alam mo yun, mga seasoning na kailangan i-brush ulit sa meat. Diba? Why not? So, maganda. I mean, for less than $50, everything is in here. Of course, don't expect na high class, but it gets the job done. Gloves, mittens, whatever you call this. Enough to hold mga hot pans, pots, whatever. Then, of course, again, meron na naman brush. Probably mga dipping sauces or whatever. We don't know. Anyway, so marami. Marami siya. Of course, sa grill, of course, grill marks. Pero may mga gusto kang i-grill pero mahirap lutuin sa grill. Like for example, isda. Diba? Yung isda kasi is mas madaling masira, lalo na pag dumikit sa grill. So, or vegetables, diba? Na, or yung mga madaling mahulog. So, bumili ako nito. This is more of a parang mat para pwede kong ipatong doon sa grill. Tapos lutuin. Dito ko ilagay yung mga isda or anything na hindi kailangan, na hindi pwede doon mismo sa grill itself, yung direct grill. So, yan. Bili ko muna. Hindi ko pa nagagamit kasi technically speaking, ginawa ko lang naman, nag-ihaw ng liempo. Alam mo yung typical na liempo ihaw sa palengke? Ganun lang kami. Yeah. First, we've got tongs na ito yung talagang stainless kasi hindi yung pwede yung mga plastic or yung silicone. Ito talaga, pang meat, di ba? So, meron siyang ridges para kahit papano. Kung sakaling kailangan mong kunin yung, i-flip yung meat, yung ridges na to, didikit or kakainin talaga, kakagatin mabuti yung meat or whatever. Para better grasp. Of course, we've got the scissors. We've got ito, flipper, yung shansi ata to. And then, of course, pagka gusto, tusok, sausages for that matter. So, yan. Kailangan nang ibalik kasi delikado. Very, medyo delikado kasi mga sharp edges, mga pwede kang masugat. So, be careful with it. You've got injection. Kung sakaling gagawa tayo ng cured ham or tocino or whatever, pwede. I've got what else do I need? Do I have right here? Of course, marami. Anyway, ooh, pang kebab, di ba? Kunyari gusto ko magluto ng kebab or yeah, skewers, ika nga, mga pang maganda. So which is really really good. Yeah, I guess that's it. For dapat may thermometer dito. Yun. So, may thermometer dito. So thermometer, pwede mong isaksak kung anong desired heat na gusto mo sa meat. So yun. Anyway, yun lang. So anyway, so tabi muna tayo dyan. And then of course, since meron tayo nito, bumili rin ako nito. Ito, heavy duty grill cleaner. Kasi itong heavy duty grill cleaner, of course, yung mga dumidikit doon, kailangan mo linisan, di ba? So, mahirap. So, kailangan ng ganito para ma-dissolve ka agad. Siyempre, ayaw mo namang iwan din na madumi yun. So, bumili ako nito from Home Depot, I think. MasterChef, Canadian Tire. And they have this. So, ngayon, since griller, bumili ako ng grill, kailangan ko rin bumili ng cover. Kasi dito sa Canada nga, sa Edmonton, di ba? Nagsusnow, umuulan, araw. So, you need to protect it as well. Kasi otherwise, pwede mag-rust, di ba? So, bumili ako nitong cover from Amazon. This is Amazon Basics. Amazon Basics naman, para siyang Kirkland ng Costco. Very reliable. Marami akong binili na Amazon Basics. For example, yung mga mabibigat namin na spoons and forks, yung mga utensils. Doon ko rin, Amazon Basics brand. Very classy. So, ito, yung cover niya, malaki siya eh, for large. So, mabigat. So, kung makikita niyo mabigat, isamahan niyo akong ilagay ito mamaya. Diba? Cover. Diba? So, para lang din maprotektahan. Very important na lagyan ng cover para hindi masira. And then, of course, since gumagamit ako ng suit, napapansin ko lately, I know, my wife has been trying to, dito sa Canada, okay, since pumupunta ako ng korte, most of the time, gumagamit ako ng suit, so most of the time, naka-dress shirt ako. Pagka regular t-shirt or regular clothes, usually, hindi mo mapapansin yung lukot, yung wrinkle, pagka regular shirt lang. Pero kasi sa akin, since silk siya or satin siya or iba yung tela, mapapansin mo, and considering na dapat played out maganda, mahirap din. I don't wanna put too much stress on my wife now in terms of kasi pag ang ginagawa niya pagkatapos ng laba, i-dryer niya yung dryer, kailangan i-wash out niya, take it out kaagad and then hang it, di ba? Regardless how much she tries to do that, ang effect, ganun pa rin. So, naisip ko, planchahin na lang. Okay? So, bumili ako nito, again, Maytag, steam iron, para kahit papano. Ito, again, mura, and has good reviews from Amazon. So, binili ko na lang siya from Amazon. Mura lang siya eh. Steam brand is Maytag. I mean, at the end of the day, diba? Ang importante sa akin, gumagana. And at least, diba, kung sakali, tansyahin ko, hindi na mahirapan si misis, diba? Para naman sa dress shirts ko lang naman. Kasi yung dress shirts, medyo maselan talaga. At saka, hirap talaga pagka, mahirap talaga kahit na i-dryer mo at ilabas mo kagad. Okay. Since meron na akong plancha, of course, bumili rin ako ng kabayo, yung iron board. Pero itong pinagkaiba nitong ironing board na binili ko is that this is not something that is a full ironing board, but rather ito yung ipapatong mo lang sa bed. Since mataas naman yung bed namin, naisip ko, ang hirap din kasi pagka yung iron board i-set up mo, mabigat, di ba? Komplikado, it takes so much space. Ito, maliit lang. Papatong ko lang doon sa loob na laundry room. So, ganito lang siya kaliit. Okay? So, ganito lang. This is Amazon Basics brand. So, ganyan lang siya kaliit. Patong mo lang siya wherever you want to, where you intend to make plancha. And that's it. Di ba? Although, yeah, hopefully sana magustuhan ni Mrs. But I think she will. Kasi ganyan lang siya, oh. Boom! Di ba? Plancha. Di ba? Gan lang. Di ba? Meron kaming iron board sa apartment noon, sa dati namin tinitirahan. Sobrang laki, sobrang haba. So, ang hirap. Di ba? So, and besides, hindi naman nila ginagamit kasi nga, usually yung mga damit nila, cotton, na hindi pansin yung wrinkle. Pero akin kasi, syempre, dress shirt, kailangan talaga hirap. And then lastly, of course, guys, ang pinaka star of the vlog ko ngayon is this. Kung mapapansin nyo, this is a Dell laptop. Again, what I did was, I made a vlog about the laptop that I received from Dell. Unfortunately, maganda siya, maganda yung specs. Makikita nyo, tingnan nyo na lang yung comment below, yung description. Unfortunately, hindi ko siya ginagamit kasi syempre bago eh. Ayaw kong gamitin masyado. But unfortunately, when I used it, sira pala. So, ang daming problema, corrupted daw yung hard drive, corrupted daw yung Windows, eventually corrupted daw yung motherboard. So what they did was they I tried customer support over the phone. It didn't work. They sent someone from Dell to actually see and try fixing this, my laptop. Unfortunately, it won't work. It will still have the same problem. So, no choice. Yung tao na yon, for yung technician nila, yung technician from Dell himself said that he couldn't fix it. So, that's when they decided, okay, let's replace it again. Okay, so this is a replacement of the replacement laptop of the original laptop. So this is not something that, hopefully, this is not something that is newly purchased. Okay, this is just a replacement of that one. So I'm just gonna open it again, just to show you what it looks like. It should be. Okay, so this is covered by the warranty. Usually, maganda sa Canada, ang Dell Canada, if they have decided that a replacement of system, a replacement system is appropriate, hindi yung repair lang, they would usually provide a brand new one. In the US, if they decide to say, for example, replace a part or replace a system, they would only replace with a refurbished one as much as possible. Okay? So, yun ang, that's a good thing about Canada. They will provide a brand new one. But it's hard. I mean, ako, kung dati, I would recommend you to go for Dell. Now, don't. Okay? Based from my experience, so the problem was, I had my laptop, okay, purchased. And then, when I reported that it was having problems, na, it's broken, it won't start, they tried everything. This is the original, so I've got, this is the third one. Original, replacement number one, and this is the second, replacement number two, which is this one. The problem was, at that time, ang hirap. You would have to go through the motion of going because technical support will direct you to someone from India. I know this because of their accent. Eventually, they would just promise you to do things, and whatever you have discussed with them, it's really, really hard. Like, okay, the person that I talked to, say person number one that I talked to, guaranteed this. Okay. And then eventually, when I tried to make a follow-up, the second one or the person that I would be talking to would be reading the record and say, unfortunately, we don't have that. So back to square one. I would have to explain again, This is complicated because my laptop, I purchased it not from Dell, but from someone, okay? And then, and worst part was, he declared the laptop that I bought as stolen. So unfortunately, hindi ko malagyan ng warranty on my own, for my, on my, under my own name. Ang siguro kung may pakonsuelo, he bought warranty for that laptop. So technically speaking, yung laptop at that time may warranty pa. So yun pala, Dell was asking him, that guy, to actually return the laptop, which is the laptop that I bought, yung the original one, in order for him, for them to transfer. So binenta niya sa akin yun, declared it as stolen. He bought another one. Dell replaced that stolen one with a new one. So technically speaking, he gained something from that transaction. So away kami, sinabihan ko siya, Canadian, no, I don't want any trouble. It's yours. Okay. So problem is, it took time. From January, I received it end of February. And then eventually, when I received it, this one, the first replacement, I noticed the problem again and then called them up again. So it was March, and then look at me now, end of April, and I just received this. Wala akong nagamit na laptop. So in terms of customer satisfaction, I don't think there is. Okay? Dell is not one of those. Kung hindi mo pagagalitan, if you're not gonna be on top of this situation, lalamunin ka nila. Okay? They will just brush you aside. Ako, every week, kasi they promised me that within 30 days, they will send me the replacement. Every week, I would be calling them just to get an update. Sasabi nila, oh, wala pang approval. Doon. So, pinagsabi. Anyway, so it came. So, this one, siguro, pakonsuelo din naman sa kanila, this is a high-end model of Dell, yung XPS. This is a 15-inch, 4K, whatever. Hindi ko lang maintindihan. They are saying that because of pandemic, it's hard to source out parts. They've been telling me that, kasi this is a 2020 or 2021 model. Or 2020 for that matter. Dapat, ang sinasabi nila, since this is a 2020 model, ang hirap mag-source out ng parts. Parang sa akin, huh? I think it should be the opposite. Considering that this is a brand new one, parts should be more available on newer part, or newer brand, or newer models, di ba? Yung dati, yun ang mas mahirap. Kasi nga, dapat ang focus mo is makabenta ng marami dito para just in case maraming mong nabentahan, nasira, it would be easier for you. So, ewan ko. So, it arrived today. Sana, ayoko nang magkaroon ng problema. Sana matapos ko na to. I won't recommend Dell, okay, for you guys to buy, especially if you're in Canada or in the US. If the warrant, the customer support really sucks. It takes time. May 6 ata yung expiration ng warranty ko, and since January until May, I never received anything. I was not, sabi ko kahit loan, i-loan nyo muna ako ng laptop, I would be glad to do it. But nope. They don't. So, paano yung warranty ko during that time? Diba? Kung ma-extend nila, tawagan ko mamaya. Pero kung ma-extend nila, then good. But if not, diba? Sayang yung binayad mo. Anyway, so ito na yun. So, those are the things that I... Yeah. Those are the only things for today. Thank you for joining me today, guys. I appreciate you watching the entire video. Please don't forget to like this video, share this video to your friends. Subscribe to our channel. Click on that notification bell down below so that you'll be updated in our future videos. Para masaya tayo lahat, okay? With that, guys, maraming salamat. Bye!